guys, this is just a video preview of the new Silverstone HTP model from the Grandia series. We're talking about the GD10 cabinet. At first, let's say that this is a preview, so you will find a written review in our portal. There you will find a lot of interesting photos and details, so we suggest you to read it. Anyway, this cabinet it's very interesting because it's close in size externally to Micra ATX based GD04 and GD05. Yet it's capable of fitting the most important full-size components, including wider ATX motherboards, SSI CB, such as, for example, the Air OG or other gaming-centric models. Apart the introduction, let's check the specifications together. It has an aluminium front door with plastic front panel and rigid 0.8 steel body, for example, the upper part and some parts of the lateral chassis. The model name, it's SST GD10B, for example, and this is the black version, but we honestly don't know if they will release some other versions with other colors. We don't think so. But anyway, about the cooling system, we find that to the right part, there's a giant filter for two 120mm fans that are in an intake configuration. It's very easy to insert the filter. As you can see, I just used one end. To the left part, we find two other filters for two 120mm fan, but they list just one, just because the other one it's for the PSU, which is placed here. All these filters are removable, so it's very easy to clean and have a remove dust. Okay. And we also find that in the top there is an expansion card vent, for example, for the graphic cards or the expansion slot, the vertical one. On the back we find that they've inserted two 80mm placements. You won't find any fan here, but I'm not optimal solution if you utilize any sync from Silverstone, which is compatible with this configuration. I don't remember the name, the exact model, but if you go to the Silverstone portal and in our review, you will find all the informations. This cabinet, it has a 7+1 expansion slots. As we've said, there's also an aluminum door. So, where are the I/O ports? You just need to open it. There's a rotating mechanism. And there's a 5.25 inches insertion. And two USB 3.0 and also a mic and audio in, the power and the reset button. So that's all for the frontal part. About the compatibility, we can install a standard PS2 ATX PSU. They suggest to install a 180mm PSU, but it's compatible up to 22cm. We decided to use this tiny monster, which is the new Strider Gold S series 1500 watts, a fantastic PSU that we will review shortly. Anyway, so That was the compatibility for the PSU. About the CPU cooler, we can install up to 138 mm here. It weighs 4.8 kilograms. The dimensions are 442 of width, 171.8, and 372 depth. For volume, in the interior part of 27.4 liters. So the volume it's not so prominent, but it's a very high. It has a very high efficiency in the placement of the components, as we will see right now. So let's open it and check the inside. We have decided to install a very powerful configuration. You can see that we've used the two R9290 AMD cards. This is a killer configuration. You can do almost everything, also mining if you want, cryptocurrencies, for example, X11 algorithms or something like that. For example, Monero XMR, it seems good. Anyway, this is an ATX board, motherboard, a gigabyte one, and which is an UD3 for reference. And this is an Intel boxed CPU cooler. And you can see that in the inside we find the two 120 mm fan pre-installed. So it has a technically it should be a positive pressure case because there are two fans that they've got an intake configuration, but also there. Unfortunately, installing a 180 mm PSU, we needed to remove that fan. So, if you want to install this PSU, that could be a problem. Anyway, you can install an 80 mm fan right there, if you wish. So, here, let's have a look directly. As you can see here, we could find some problems regarding the cable management, but you need to understand that this is a very complex configuration, and I haven't made the best possible cable management in the inside. Sorry. Okay. Because you can do a lot better. My intention is to show you what is possible with a very short time. Anyway, you can install an HDD, a common HDD 3.5 inches in the bottom part, but also to the upper part, but you need to remove the 5.25 inches DVD. Okay, the installation it's clean, and this is a very powerful system, but obviously you could also opt for different VGAs. For example, this is a GeForce GTX 750 Ti, a very interesting model, or even add something like this, which is also a GTX 750 Ti, but a very strange and rare model, which is a low profile one. But we suggest you to insert something like that, because you can do a lot of different things, but with this format factor. This is almost as perfect. Trying to to think about an HTPC case, installing such things, it's a phenomenal achievement. So let us know what you think about it. Read our written review in our portal, which is in Italian, but I hope that you could utilize the Google Translator. We have made a lot of photos, and so let's share some thoughts. And thank you for the attention.